Hello, today I'm going to show you what Elite Dangerous gameplay is like on the Yaw VR Motion Simulator. It's a short video where I show you how to get everything up and running, and then I'll share some impressions in the game. So the first thing you need to do, of course, is turn on your Yaw Simulator. I already have it turned on here. Then you should calibrate the Yaw Simulator. I use the Yaw VR Config app on my phone for that. Put the Yaw Sim in the right position and then hold the C button on the app. This is all explained in more detail in the manual. Then turn on Steam VR and make sure your headset and both controllers are on. I hung one of the controllers at the back of my chair. That's the one I'll use for motion compensation. You'll need that so that the tracking doesn't get confused as your chair is rotating but your head may stay still. Now, let's turn on the game and sit in the simulator. Okay, the game has started as you can see. So what I'm going to do now is go to Steam VR menu and I go to desktops because in here I got the Yaw VR game engine already launched. And what you need to do is connect to the Yaw VR game engine with the simulator. And we need to start a simulator as well. So I'm going to select Elite Dangerous from this list at the left. And for Elite Dangerous, you don't have any additional steps to connect the game with this game engine. So what you need to do is, of course, start the game first, which we already have. And then you can start the plugin by pressing this red start plugin button right here. Okay, and then we can start the device, which is the Yaw Simulator, by pressing this button at the bottom right here. Oh, as you can see, simulator is moving already a little bit, so that's good. Okay, and now we need to put the game on the foreground or else it's not going to work. Okay, that's good. And there's one more thing that we need to do, which is go to the OpenVR Input Emulator. This is a free tool, by the way, which you can download if you Google it. And then we need to turn on motion compensation. So I'm going to select the controller that I have velcroed at the back of my chair here. And I think it should be this one. Now you can select motion compensation from this drop down menu and then click apply. Okay, this is the right controller. If it's not the right controller, you will notice it straight away because it will move with the controller that you have in your hand. Like the whole screen will move with it. And it's super uncomfortable. So you will know straight away. Then the last thing I recommend to do is to reset your seated position also in the Steam VR menu because the chair has pitched upward a little bit. So we need to make sure that everything is correct with the game as well. Okay, I'm done. So I'm going to put the Steam VR controller down. And just to show you, I also have my wireless keyboard over here. Could be handy with this game. So that's why I got it here. I also have the Thrustmaster T-Flight Hotas X right here. And I'm just going to try and use that as much as possible. So let's start the game now. Ooh, let me show you a little bit what the Yaw VR Motion Simulator is like in Elite Dangerous. As you can see, I'm yawing right now and my chair is yawing with me. I don't have a limit on my yaw, so I can actually yaw 300 degrees in my room. You can put a limit too if you like don't have a cable management like I do. Like I have all my cables on top of my head instead of on the floor so that it doesn't get tangled up. And okay, so let's try rolling. Oh, it's so strange, guys. It's so cool though. It's very immersive. It feels realistic to me. Of course, I have no idea what it feels like to be in a spaceship, but it does feel realistic to me. Okay, this is pitching forward, pitching backward. So I'm going to go to the target right now. Okay, let's engage. Let's try it out. Drive charging. Oh, it's charging. So just so you know, by the way, I restarted the whole game. Because I played Elite Dangerous, like I think like 3 years ago. That's when I started, but I didn't get far. So I don't remember much about the game. I'm not a pro player for sure. So that's why I cleared my save and I'm right now in one of the first tutorials. Oh, that's so awesome. Just felt the chair vibrate just when I was going into hyper jump. Or it's called hyperspace jump. Whoa! Wow, the chair just went crazy. That was awesome though. Okay, here we go. Okay, let's target this. Whoa. What's going on? Okay, so this movement's a little crazy. Like my whole screen is shaking right now and it's making a lot of noise. I think it's because of the motion compensation because I can't read the text anymore. I wonder if there's a fix for that. Let's try a training mission. I want to show you what combat is like, so let's try that out real quick. Ooh, here we go, let's do this.
Right on time. Don't get too excited though.
Okay, targeted. Target is wanted. Okay, let's go there.
Time to deploy your hard points, Commander.
Oh yeah. Let's do that first. Oh, wrong button. this one, right? Oh yeah, here we go. Multi-cannon. Reloading. Here he is. Oh yes. So far, I'm really enjoying playing Elite Dangerous with my Yaw VR motion simulator. I think all the movements are almost one-on-one, like I don't feel any latency. And I like that I'm able to yaw 360 degrees. Everything is just moving like in the game. And that's just very cool. Especially like how I'm sitting in this chair and it feels like I'm actually sitting in that space station because of that foot holder, for example. But then also really recommend playing the game with a joystick and throttle. It all makes it more immersive. I think the only thing that I would like to fix is that the shakiness of the motion compensation when I'm in hyperspace jump. I wonder if that's because of that or something else, but I'll definitely have to check that out. I think I showed you what this Yaw VR motion simulator can do in Elite Dangerous already. So I'm just going to step out and end this video here. But before you step out, always turn off your simulator first. Like press the stop button on your app and then you can like gracefully go out of your simulator. Or you can also turn off the tracker that's between your legs. So I'm going to do that and I'm going to exit the game. So as you can probably tell, I definitely need some more practice in Elite Dangerous.